A very, very good evening. Welcome to the platform of An Academy. So today we are going to discuss a very important images, that is hysterosalpingogram images. So past 2-3 exams, every time we have been getting HSD images, as well past 3 days also at 7 p.m. daily I've done image-based sessions, which you can all have a look, right? So you have something called as Plus subscription on the platform of An Academy, as well as Iconic subscription, where you have An Academy Plus Prep Ladder, and the great discounts running on it. So you can grab those offers, and you can use a code of Ramya Life for further 10% discount. So, how is your preparation going on? I hope you're all doing well. And last 10 days, I know this is the time where most of the time we feel anxious and apprehensive. But just stay strong. You have all read very well. So, it's the time finally to perform. Very good evening to everyone. Right. So before I go per se to the images of hysterosalpingogram, so basically here we do the radiographic evaluation of the uterus and the fallopian tubes, right? What is the main purpose of the HSG? Where do we use HSG mainly? So the main purpose of HSG is it is used as a first line for checking the tubal patency. It is used as a first line for checking the tubal patency. Very good, right? But the only disadvantage of this is because of the dye, there can be bilateral corneal spasm, and this bilateral corneal spasm will give you false positive results. False po positive results, right? So there can be a chance of physiological spasm, right? Now, so HSG is mainly done indications for infertility. That's the main to check for the tubal patency. Apart from that, for recurrent spontaneous abortion, ideally congenital anomalies of the uterus, we find out, but according to the recent Williams, it tells that HSG has no role. Your investigation of choice is MRI or 3D USG, and gold standard is laparoscopy. You can use this post-operative to evaluate whether tubal ligation has been done appropriately, and for reversal also we can use. We can also use this to prove that tubal occlusion has happened after transcervical cervical sterilization, that is Assure, that microcoil which goes hysteroscopically. So after 3 months, the entire fallopian tubes will fibrose. So there to see whether it is occluded or not. Now last is very, very important point, guys. It is not just diagnostic, it also has therapeutic role. It is not just diagnostic, it also has a therapeutic role. How? 60% of the time, whenever there are small mucus plugs in the fallopian tube, when you push the dye, these plugs are removed with the dye, and that's how it leads to the pregnancy. So it also has therapeutic role. So what are the contraindications? Contraindications when you have suspected pregnancy, acute infection, acute vaginal bleeding. If you have done recent dilatation and curettage, you should never do it immediate pre and post menstrual phase because it can lead to endometriosis. And when there is tubal or uterine surgery within the last 6 weeks. So these are the contraindications. Which day it has to be done is an important MCQ. So on which day you should do this? You should do it between 8th to 12th day. Not before 8th day, when she is menstruating, if you do, menstrual blood can go back, retrograde blood flow. So, iatrogenically, you are creating endometriosis. Not after 12th day, because if she is pregnant and implantation would have happened, you would disturb it. So, ideally, it is done between 8th to 12th day. Okay? So, what is this? What is this instrument which you are seeing? So this is used, this was used to do HSG, but it is outdated. This is called Rubin's cannula. Rubin's cannula. So blue cork you see here, this is called Rubin's cannula. Okay, but this is outdated, but they can give you image base. Now what do we use nowadays for HSG is this one. And what is this? This is called Leech-Wilkinson's cannula. Leech-Wilkinson's cannula. So it has a spiral triangle in front. This is important. It has a spiral triangle in front. So this you push it into the cervix. Not Carmen's. This is Leech-Wilkinson's. Okay. So that spiral triangle, you push it into the cervix. You screw it into the cervix. That gets fixed. Then you push the dye. After that, you take X-ray. The dye will evaluate the uterus, fallopian tubes, and whether the dye has spilled outside or not. So this is, you know, little painful. You are pushing that in the cervix. And do we give any anesthesia for doing this procedure? No, we don't give any anesthesia for doing this procedure, right? So that's the another reason why it is painful. You can do it only under mild sedation. So alternate to Leech-Wilkinson's cannula is you can use pediatric Foley's catheter. You can use pediatric Foley's catheter. It is not sharp. This one you are telling. So this is the... We don't keep this one inside. This is the guide wire. We just keep this cannula. We don't use the guide wire. Right. So, Leech-Wilkinson's cannula. Alternate, you can also use pediatric Foley's catheter. Okay. Yes, very good, Sheena. The dye which we use here, is meglulamine diatriozoate. Meglulamine diatriozoate, right? And meglulamine diatriozoate is a water-based dye. You have oil-based and water-based. What we use is water-based, which is meglulamine diatriozoate. It's also called urographin. No need to go into so much depth anyway. Now, so you instill inside, this is a pediatric Foley's catheter, you push the dye and you see the dye coming up. So now we'll see the images pertaining to the HSG, guys. So this is the first image. So here is the cannula. This is the cervix. This is the uterine cavity. I want you to comment on the cervix and uterine cavity. Are they normal or not normal? Normal or not normal? Cervix is normal, looks normal, right? Uterus also is pear shaped, so normal. See both sides, fallopian tubes also is also visualized. Can you see the fallopian tube? And then the dye is coming out. This side also, this is the fallopian tube and here is the dye coming out. So this is the absolute normal HSG. Yes. So, bilateral spill is present. So, this is a normal HSG. This is a normal HSG with bilateral spill positive. Okay. Let's go to see the next one. How do you want to comment about this one? I can't see the cervix. And what has happened to the uterus here? Uterus is like falling in front, right? So uterus is antiverted, excess antiversion, right? But bilaterally spill is present. Bilateral spill is present. So always follow the fallopian tube and see for the spill. So but uterus is acutely antiverted. Pura aage ja raha hai. Acute antiversion, right? Okay, now again a very beautiful picture. Here, cervix, can you see a small indentation? This is a cesarean scar, guys. This is a cesarean scar. So again, a normal uterus, bilaterally, spillage is present. So this is again normal, but it has a cesarean scar demonstrated. Okay. Right, comment about this picture now. Comment about this picture. Let me zoom it. We'll go from the cervix. So cervix normal, uterus normal, cornua, bilateral cornua also dye is going out, right? Yes, this is a post-cornual block. This is a post-cornual block. So after the cornua, at the level of isthmus. No, here this is a cornu, no? Interstitium mein dye ja raha hai. After that, it dye is not able to go. So at the level of isthmus, it is blocked. So it is bilateral isthmic block. Bilateral isthmic block. Where do you see bilateral isthmic block? Post-tubectomy. So this is a picture of post-tubectomy HSG. This is a picture of post-tubectomy HSG. Tuberculosis mainly causes bilateral corneal block. Now I'll show you pictures. Ideally, if you have a patient with TB, can you do HSG? HSG is contraindicated. HSG is contraindicated. Yes, HSG is contraindicated in patients with tuberculosis. But if you have done HSG for infertility and then later you find out it's a tuberculosis. So what are all the different findings we have pertaining to tuberculosis and HSG, right? So we will see all that, and there are many pictures, and I could collect all of them, and there are beautiful pictures which we will now see. So this is the first one. What do you comment on? Do you want to comment on this? So this is the cervix. This is the uterus. Yes, cervix hai. This is uterus. In the fallopian tube, dye is coming out, but how is this? What is this appearance called as? Anybody? Cotton wool appearance. So there are different changes in the fallopian tube pertaining to tuberculosis. So this is one of the change. It will show cotton wool appearance. No, this is not tobacco pouch. I'll show you tobacco pouch. This is like a cotton wool. You know that cotton ka wool is there. No, it's like that. So this is cotton wool appearance. Okay. Where else do you see cotton wool spots? Where else do you see cotton wool spots? So this is cotton wool appearance pertaining to obstetrics and gynecology because of tuberculosis. Where else do you see cotton wool spots? Yes, I'm actually waiting any one of you to answer. Very good, Dr. Tina. Very good, Priyanka. So we have it in the Paget's disease. So these are the cotton wool spots in the skull. These are the cotton wool spots in the skull. This is seen in Paget's disease. And this is the cotton wool spots in the retina. Cotton wool spots in the retina is seen with diabetic retinopathy. Right? So these are the two other places where we see the cotton wool spots. Next beautiful image, guys. So this is again the cervix, uterus. How is the fallopian tube? Fallopian tube is not normal. You can definitely check whether it is hypertensive retinopathy or diabetic retinopathy, but in retinopathy also one more you find it, okay? Just have a clarity, just check that one, okay? Pertaining to orbs, this is the cotton wool appearance, okay? Right, this is the beaded appearance, beaded tube, beautiful, no, again, beaded tube. So beaded tube again is characteristic of tuberculosis. So they can give you such image and they can ask you what is the diagnosis here. So you have to go for the tuberculosis. Okay. Right. This is one more. Both sides you have beaded tube here. This also is beaded. This also is beaded. Okay. Right. What is this one? So this is called sperm head appearance. This is called sperm head. See, it looks like a sperm head, right? This is called sperm head appearance. And the other side, you have it as a golf club appearance. So this is called golf club appearance. And this is sperm head appearance. So these are all the different abnormalities of the tube pertaining to tuberculosis. And everywhere, see, tubes are blocked. Post all these changes, you don't find dye coming out. Tubes are blocked, right? This is called lead pipe appearance. This is called lead pipe. So earlier days, they used to use that cigar, no, which will be like this. So this is the lead pipe appearance. Okay. What do you want to comment on this one? So most of the time I have students answering this as unicornuate, but this is not unicornuate, guys. So this is cervix. This is cervix. This is the uterus. Here I have one cornu. Here I have one cornu and this is the fundus. So, but beyond cornu, I don't see the dye going out. If I can just zoom it for you all. Beyond cornu, I don't have the dye going out, right? So, this is bilateral corneal block. This is bilateral corneal block. And this bilateral corneal block looks like a unicornuate uterus. So this is called as pseudo-unicornuate uterus. This is called as pseudo-unicornuate uterus. So this is bilateral corneal block and this is called as pseudo-unicornuate uterus. Again, this is a picture of, this is one of the finding of tuberculosis. This next picture has come in the exam for NEET as well as FMG. So what is this next one? This is the favorite which you were all answering before. So, sausage shaped both sides. So, this is bilateral tobacco pouch appearance. These are the hydrosalpinx. You can also call it as bilateral tobacco pouch appearance. This is called bilateral tobacco pouch appearance, right? Okay, can you answer this question? HSG shows the following condition. All of the following symptoms can be seen with this except. So again, bilateral corneal block and even the uterus doesn't look normal. There are multiple filling defects. What is this HSG commenting? What is the comment on this HSG? First of all, what is the diagnosis here? This is called honeycomb appearance, or it's also called as moth-eaten appearance. And this is seen in, very good, Asherman syndrome. This is seen in Asherman syndrome. Okay, so Asherman syndrome, you'll have hypomenorrhea, you will have amenorrhea, you will have infertility. Less commonly, oligomenorrhea. So Asherman can be post-tuberculosis. Asherman can be post-tuberculosis, right? So the answer here is D. Oligomenorrhea means infrequent cycles. Here they'll have basically less bleeding. So hypomenorrhea more common. Yeah, we call it as honeycomb. I've written here honeycomb or moth-eaten. This is the honeycomb or moth-eaten appearance. Okay? So now we will just quickly look all the images once again as a quick revision. So pertaining to TB, we had cotton wool appearance, beaded appearance, sperm head appearance or golf club appearance, lead pipe appearance, pseudo unicornuate uterus, tobacco pouch appearance, right? And last is the Asherman's, which is called as honeycomb or moth-eaten appearance. So all these are the different abnormalities pertaining to tuberculosis, which can be picked up on a HSG, right? I hope they are clear to all of you. So now quickly, we'll also see the uterine abnormalities, guys, because uterine abnormalities picture of HSG also comes in exam. So we'll quickly go through the uterine abnormality pictures also HSG. But for uterine abnormalities, that is uterine anomalies, the first line is MRI or 3D USG. Okay, 32-year-old patient presents with infertility. HSG done shows as follows. What is the management? So she has presented to you with infertility and you have done a HSG which is showing this abnormality. So they have used your Foley's catheter instead of Leech Wilkinson's. In the uterus you find something. What is this? Okay, both sides fallopian tube. Are they patent or not patent? So both sides fallopian tube is patent. Can you see the dry coming out? Both sides fallopian tube is patent, but you see a mass inside the uterus. Very good, Shashi Murugan. So this is a fibroid, guys. This is a fibroid. So fibroid can also be picked up on HSG. So now as you know the diagnosis, now you answer. So you are seeing a fibroid here. You're seeing a fibroid here. What is the management? IVF, hysteroscopic myomectomy, IUI, ovulation induction with clomiphene citrate. Very good, excellent. So it is a hysteroscopic myomectomy. So whenever there is a fibroid and when they want to go for a, when they are presenting to you with infertility, you can always go for myomectomy, right? So this is a fundal fibroid. This is a picture showing fundal fibroid. Here the fallopian tubes are not patent and you have a fundal fibroid. Now we'll see the images of uterine anomalies, guys. So we have American Fertility Society classification as well as we have ESHRAE classification. So I prefer using the American Fertility Society classification. And my mnemonic for American Fertility Society classification is mud be sad. So bacha fell in the mud and he became sad. Bacha fell in the mud and he became sad. Okay. So the mnemonic is mud be sad. So M stands for Mullerian agenesis or MRKH. U, unicornuate uterus. So they have single fallopian tube and banana shaped uterus. D stands for Didelphus. Two uterus, two cervix, two vaginas. B stands for bicornuate. Two uterus, single cervix, can have septation, single vagina. S is septate. A, arcuate. Arcuate is the heart shaped. Last D is diethyl stilbestrol related abnormalities. Now here we will see most important images pertaining to the HSG. Not going into the detail of Mullerian abnormalities now, because we will see the images. I have spoken about Mullerian abnormalities many times prior. So what is this first image? So this has come, this image is the MRI image, and this has come as an image based question for NEET 2017. So can you comment on the first picture? Cervix. How is the uterine cavity? Uterine cavity is like a banana shape, and you have single fallopian tube. So this is nothing but unicornuate uterus. This is nothing but unicornuate uterus, right? Next one. Two uterine cavities, two cervix, two cannulas. You have inserted two cannulas here. One, two. Matlab, two different vaginal cavities are also there. And two cervix are there, and two uterus is there. Actually, both fallopian tubes don't look patent. What is this one? Very good. This is didelphus. This is didelphus, right? Now, again, next, cervix, two uterine cavities. I also want you to see every time fallopian tube. You know, you should learn how to see the fallopian tubes. So both sides fallopian tubes are patent and dye is coming out here, right? Now, actually this is not an ideal way. HSG is not good for diagnosing between, differentiating between bicornuate and septate. But olden thing is that if the intracornual angle is more than 60 degrees and intercornual distance is more than 4 centimeters, it is bicornuate. I repeat, this is not an ideal way, but based on what I have findings, this looks like a bicornuate. MRI would be the best, right? Now this one, cervix, two, it looks again two uterine cavities, and fallopian tube shows tobacco pouch, guys, here, right? So here the intercornual angle is less than 60 degrees and intercornual distance is less than 4 centimeters. So this is septate. This is septate, right? So this is the T-shaped uterus, which we see diethyl stilbestrol related abnormalities. So diethyl stilbestrol related abnormalities will lead to infantile T-shaped uterus. So those were the HSG images, which are very important to all of us. And I hope this session was beneficial for all of you and you could see all the images. So from, again, I'll be starting a series from day after tomorrow at 7 p.m. where we will be doing MCQs, where we'll be doing the clinical based MCQs. Okay, so till then, thank you all of you. Keep studying. All the best. Stay safe, stay healthy, and be positive, guys. Don't think much. You all are going to do great, right? Thank you.